Hi, it's Maggie Davis at Minnie the Minx UK on YouTube and The Captain. I've made this envelope junk journal envelope mini album memory book, a unique keepsake, and the cover is done on envelopes as an envelope. It's like two pages glued together for an envelope shape, and inside I've done various envelopes that I've got side pockets, etc., for you to put things in, and obviously I've put some things in. So the original template came from Genevieve Designs, and I've used some of the old paper designs as well in here, and I've just basically put my own spin on it. It's a great way of putting your thoughts or special moments, etc., into a little album, and you can take it with you. Pop it in your handbag, keep it in your bedroom drawer, on the side of your table. If you were a student at college, uni, or at school, or if you're grown up and you just want something, I mean, it's a lovely little book. It can stand up. So, it's got card and paper, etc. in it. It's got side pockets. I've added belly bands. There's tuck spots, pockets, tags, envelopes. And little mini books that I've made as well to go inside it. And I've distressed everything with Tim Holtz Vintage Photo. It's acid free, just that's my favourite. It gives an old look, and I just think it's nice. So I'm just going to let you see it. I've added tags, etc. As I say, I've used raffin for the signature inside it to attach everything, and then wrapped it round quite a few times, and just I just thought that gave it quite a nice look as a little book. There is beads. I've added a bead here, quite nice, on either side of the raffin, and I've just tied it to secure it. I've put this little label on the front and a little diamante gem in the middle there. I've used this sort of cord, this twine at the top. These are in my tags that are inside the mini journal, and it's vintage, like a vintage lady on the front, some vintage writing here, and the vintage lady on the back again, and that is the spine of it. That's the raffin going down, and I've actually tied it there and then just wrapped round several times, maybe three times or something, and just tied it in a bow here at the front. So we'll have a look inside, but the size of it is 4.5 inches times 5.5 inches, and that's about 10 centimetres by 14.5. As I say, it's a little mini journal, and it's ideal for keeping your memories of that special place or moment in. So we'll have a wee look inside. If you didn't like it that long on the twine, you could snip it, but I actually quite like the fact that it's got all this raffin on it going around. So that's the tag on the front. I've glued it on, and you could put your name or whatever, or just leave it like that. It's a kind of vintage tag that I thought was nice with a rose there, and as I said, there's a little diamante bead glued on. So as I said, it's been done. If I opened it like that, that is like an envelope, and basically it's been two bits of paper glued together, etc., and it's an envelope shape, and the side here is open. It's open at either side, but I'll show you the other side when we get to it. I've got some, so it's a side pocket here, there, a place for keeping memorabilia, etc., and you can add your own. Inside it's roses, it's black paper with white roses on inside it, and I like that too. So we'll just have a quick look what I've put in inside. So I've got this little vintage tag type thing here, like it's like a postcard sort of thing, and you could put some journaling on the lines here. It's a vintage corset there on the picture, and it's blank on the back, so it'd be ideal for journaling or photos. And I've got this little, it's done with old paper, like crackly paper, and I've just made it into a little book. And you could add journaling or photos or add other memorabilia inside there. So, and I've got that slotted in the side pocket here. So we'll just slot that in at the side. Sometimes when you're on camera and you're trying to hold something a certain way, it goes in. Sometimes it's easier just to sort of do that, and you can slot it in pretty easily. And what I've done here is fussy cut out this little flower. It's a rose, and I fussy cut out this little tag, and I've just left it blank on the back. I've not put any fibres on the top, as I quite liked it like that. And you could add, you could put a picture on the back here, or journaling, entirely up to yourself. On the opposite side, I've did a pocket. I've used this old paper, it's like a crackly effect, and it's vintage, and I've added on this vintage lady's face, and I've just glued down the sides to give it, to make it into a tuck spot. So you could add journaling here, and this is just a little rosette here. It's just been fussy cut out, and it's blank on the back, and it's just showing you there's a tuck spot, or you could use it for something. So in the pocket, I've got a little envelope here made from that crackle paper, and it's thick card that I've done it with. And inside I have put a little vintage, it's this way up, it's a vintage girl, vintage lady, and made a little tag there. I've got a little, another little tag here, just one-sided, it's blank on the back. So two of the same here, two little tags or placemats. So it's old paper on the front, and it's blank on the back for you to add your own thoughts, etc. Little envelope, and I've, there's another little one of these tags that were on the front that I glued down for you. I just think, and I've put a little gem on the rose, and I just thought it looked nice in this pocket here, in the journal, just sitting there at the top. I thought it looked nice, and you could fit some more stuff in here. On the opposite side, I've done a belly band here, and I've added a yellow type rose. I fussy cut it out and just glued it down. And behind that, I've actually used my dauber for distressing, and I've done these circle type effects on there, and I like it. It looks vintagey to me, old, and that's what I was sort of going for. So we've got this pretty little tag here. It's of a mannequin top part, and a little pin there on the picture. And there's a little butterfly, and I've actually put a diamante in the middle. On the back, it's just white for you to add journaling or photos. And I've handmade this little envelope. As I said, I've distressed around everything with Tim Holtz vintage photo. It's just a little placemat inside, or a little card that matches the envelope on that side of the colour. And I just thought it looked quite cute, so just slip that back in. Sometimes they want to go in, and sometimes they like to, they like to play up when you're on camera. But I bet you everybody would say that, you know, that's just how it goes. But anyway, it slots in there. And on the opposite side, we've got this vintage, I've made a tuck spot here with this vintage lady. And I've just, all I've did is glued down the side. So it's that old paper again in the backdrop. I like that. You could doodle on this, you could add journaling, etc. And then we've got this large tag, and I really like that. It's a vintage type card, but this time it's got some pink roses in it. And I've just used this twine on top. Throughout the tags, I've used the same twine. I felt it was a sort of vintage look. They've all been distressed, as I said, around the edges with Tim Holtz, and it's just white on the back for you to add notes, journaling, etc. And it just slots back in at the side here. So this one, then, this page is an actual envelope again, and I liked this part of it. I mean, you could cut that off, but actually I like it that you're flipping it open and there's something inside it, or you could put something inside it. But I'll show you the front first before I take the inside of the, what's inside the envelope out. So basically all I've done is fussy cut out two leaves, one brown, one a sort of yellow colour. Basically, I'm trying to get the colours to match throughout the book. And I've just glued part of them, so it's creating a tuck spot at the top, a tuck spot here. And I've left that blank for you to do journaling or add a little picture. And I've just made this little tag. Well, I would assume it would go that way, but I've put it in that way. But you could put it in like that. There's a label on top for writing on, and I've used a little purple brad there. Hope you can see that, and it just slots to the side, and you could put something underneath, and then it's got this colour on the back, and then you've got the back of your label here that you could actually write on as well. So places for journaling or adding a photo and things like that, and then it just slots back in, just slips there as a tuck spot there on it. On the opposite, oh, nearly forgot, a little side pocket on the envelope. I'll see what I've put in here. We've actually got a large mat here in sort of distressed blue colouring here, and I've got this little vintage tag with an air balloon in flower, and I've just stitched down the side there with my sewing machine to give it a sort of look, and we've got this one and I've stitched along the top here. And I just thought they looked quite vintagey, and I thought, well, there's nothing on the back. You basically could write something on the back or add a little picture. And again, that just slots in the side of that envelope there. Like that. On this side, I've just made it a little belly band. And I've got a little peach flower in the middle that I fussy cut out, and I've just glued it onto the belly band. And I've actually glued this down behind there. I just think this paper is lovely on there. I know I made a tag earlier on, and with that, with the butterfly bit, it's like a really thread, a little bit lace, and a pin there, and a little butterfly, and I just think it's really nice, it stands out. So in the belly band, I've actually got a little handmade envelope here, done with that old paper. And it's like a crackly tight look. And I've just placed in one little mat in there. Little card. So it's clear on the back. And I mean, as well, you could, on your envelope here, you could do journaling on this, add a picture. And same as the front, you could use that as places, you know, as places to add memorabilia, events, things like that. And again, one of these little labels, which I think is really cute. And it's got a little diamante on that rose. And it's blank on the back for you to do what you will, what you want, I should say. So on the opposite page, I've made a little pocket here, along here. And I've just cut that out. Got a little machine that does that, but it's actually a circle, and I'm just doing half of it. Prior to getting the little circle, I actually just drew around a one pence piece, just part of the one pence piece, and cut out before I got the wee little tool to do it. So it's an idea. I've distressed it all. I've added in some of this paper on the front. I'm sure that was on one of the envelopes that I handmade. And in the pocket, again, I've used my dauber, and it's sort of like a honeycomb circle shape going in there, but I like that. What I've done. So in the pocket we've got two envelopes. We've got one of the long envelopes like that, and what's have we got inside it, and we've got a tag inside, blank on the back, so it's old paper. And again, you could use these envelopes for just adding journaling, photos, etc., but you could actually use the front, the back and the front, and you could put memorabilia on there. This one, I've added the cute little butterfly, and I've put a little gem in the middle because I just thought it was nice, and it was a contrast and added a little bit of interest, so into this envelope, and it's a little placemat tag inside, and it's just, I just thought they were nice, both of them. So I've put these inside that pocket there, and the envelope with the butterfly at the top there showing, and then we've got a pocket on this side. So I'll show you what's on the front first. I've just used a ruler. It was in a sort of brownie shape, and I cut part of it off, just glued along the top and bottom and down that, and down the inside side. And I've left this there. And so I've created a little tuck spot. I've got this little vintage dress here. It's very cute. Blank on the back, and places for you to put journaling. On this side, there is part of the envelope again. And an envelope side pocket is what it is, and in it I've got two tags. So we've got this sort of graphic type writing, and this paper on the back that you could do journaling writing, and then we've got this, which is very pretty, this vintage pink with a sort of gold button and lace here look on the paper, and it's blank on the back for you to add in your own, whatever you would like, journaling, photos, and you could add a little bit more in these side pockets of your own memorabilia, and you could actually put something on that part of it. On the opposite side, we've got another vintage lady here, and I've made it into a tuck spot. So we've got the old paper on the back, and you could put journaling in, and I've got this beautiful tag. It's a pretty bird with the bird cage and beautiful pink roses there, and I've got a little bit of this twine. And I've inked the edges, distressed them with the vintage photo, and it's blank on the back. for you to add whatever you like. The opposite side, I've done a pocket. There's your pocket, and I've just glued down, first I cut out this bow, it's like a straw bow, and I quite like that. The fact is my closure on this is raffin type straw, and I thought that was quite cute. It's vintagey looking. So inside the pocket, I've dabbed the back of this as well with my dauber, with my distressed dauber, and I like the look it gives. So we've got another one of these envelopes here, like that, and you could write on the front and back. And inside I've put a little placemat or tag, and it's blank on the back, for you to add what you would like, what you would want to add. I'll just slip that in that way. And then we've got one of these again, and I've on the little rose I've added a little diamante. I actually think it's very cute. I'll actually see if I could get that one in the opposite way, because I feel that label is the label from the envelope is getting in the way. So we'll just slot that in there. Next page we have Vintage Lady, and I've made it into a tuck spot, and we've got this graphic paper there behind. You could add a picture, and I've got this cute tag. Cute little, three little birdies with roses, and it's blank on the back, and it's the twine on the top. So the matching twine on there, and it just slots in. On the opposite side, we have an envelope side pocket here, a space for it, and I've just fussy cut out this lovely flower here, and like a button in the middle, and I've just added, it's the old paper on the back, and I've created a tuck spot, and in the tuck spot I've added these two vintage tags. Beautiful watering jug with pink roses, and I've just added a little zigzag stitch down the side with my sewing machine, and two butterflies on this one with I've sewn down, and they're both white on the back. And I've just, and another one of these little heart tags, is a little tag with a little heart there, and it's blank on the back, for you to add in what you would, anything you would like. So they just sort of slot in and sit in that. It just creates a lot more space for journaling, photos, etc. And I've got two tags in the side envelope pocket. So I've got that one, like that, and I've got this one. And again, on that, I've added a little diamante to the butterfly, just to create a little bit of interest, and it actually makes it look pretty, is what I would say to that one. So, and again here, you could, on the envelope part there, I've not glued it down or anything, I've just left it to flip up, but you could put a little bit of writing or something on that side, really up to yourself. I've got a little vintage lady at the side here, I've glued round part of her, and I've made a tuck spot here, and I've got this beautiful tag, Vintage Lady, with those beautiful pink roses again, and it's blank on the back, and you've got the twine, matching twine that runs throughout this mini journal, or I'm going to call it maybe an envelope journal. So on this side I've made a side pocket going down, and I've just added in another part of that ruler, but it's been glued down there, but I've got a side pocket here, and I've put in this large tag, but I've not added a diamante gem on this one. I've just left it plain with white on the back, and this tag with the vintage corset, and you could put some journaling in there, and this pretty large tag with roses with that twine on the top, and all blank on the back for you to add in journaling, pictures, other memorabilia. And on the opposite side, I've actually glued this straight on. It's not a tuck spot, and so you could put a picture, journaling, etc. on it. I think that's lovely, that paper. And on the back insert, there is a pink rose. It's actually peach, I think that is. A peach colour that matched the front, and I've just put in the same little tag that was in the inside of the front. And you could put journaling or a picture here, and I've just made that into a tuck spot, and then you've got the side pocket. So that's the black rose paper that's on the inside of this envelope. And I'll show you what I've put inside that. So I've put in a little book. It's white in the inside, so just open and close like that, but it gives you four, and it's old paper on the back, and it actually gives you four different places to put journaling or pictures. And you've got this vintage tag, which is the corset on it with lined bits there, and you could add journaling, and it's white on the back. So quite a lot of space here for you to add journaling, pictures, photos, tickets, whatever, of maybe places you went. And then that is the back of the book there. That's the closure on it with the vintage girl there. You could put journaling on here if you wanted. Now, I'm just going to show you it like that, open sort of thing. So I'll do that. So it's open like that. It's quite heavy, actually, because it's not just paper. I've used card as well in there. But it can stand, and I like the fact it can. And that's the tops of the tags. And all you're doing is holding that side part like that. And all you're doing is wrapping. Let's make sure I do this the right way. Wrapping it round. Typical when I'm on camera, I'll get it caught. That one, two, maybe three times there. Two, three times, and all you're doing is, I don't know if you can even see that, all you're doing is tying it into a little bow. Very easy to do. So, and when you've got, so it's just like that. It's actually so cute. When you've got more, or if you add more stuff in it, it will pack out a little bit more, hence why you've got the wrapping. So you could make it smaller. You don't need to wrap it around that many times. You could make double up your bow, etc. And I just think that's very cute. I like that. So as I said, this will be for sale on my Etsy shop, Minx Creations. I think that this is ideal for a little keepsake. It's a unique keepsake and gift, and something that you can keep your memories in. So look out for it on my Etsy shop, and I'll have the YouTube in the part underneath. I will put in my shop name, and from Etsy as well, I'll link in the video so both match up. So thank you for watching. Bye.